Satan called a worldwide conversation of demons. In his opening address, he said, "We can't keep Christians from going to church. We can't keep them from reading their Bibles and knowing the truth. We can't even keep them from forming an ultimate relationship with their Savior. Once they gain their connection with Jesus, our power over them is broken. So let them go to their churches. Let them have covered dish dinners, but steal their time, so they don't have time to develop a relationship with Jesus Christ. This is what I want you to do," said the devil. "Distract them from gaining hold of their Savior and maintaining this vital connection throughout their day." "How shall we do this?" the demon shouted. "Keep them busy in the non-essentials of life and invent schemes to occupy their minds. Tempt them to spend, 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 and borrow, borrow, borrow. Persuade the wives to go to work for long hours and husbands to work 6-7 days each week, 10-12 hours a day, so they can afford their empty lifestyles. Keep them from spending time with their children. As their families fumigate, soon their homes will offer no escape from the pleasures of work. Overstimulate their minds so they cannot hear. Entice them to play the radio or CD player whenever they drive, to keep them TV, VCR, DVD, and their PCs going constantly. This will jam their minds and break the union with Christ. Fill the coffee tables with magazines and newspapers. Pound their minds with news 24 hours a day. Invade their driving moments with billboards. Flood their mailboxes with junk mail, mail order catalogs, sweepstakes, and every kind of newsletter and promotional offer. Free products, service, and false hopes. Keep skinny, beautiful models on the magazine and TV so their husbands will believe that the outward beauty is most important and they will become dissatisfied with their wives. Keep their wives too tired to love their husbands at night. Give them headaches too. If they don't give their husbands the love they need, they will begin to look elsewhere. That will fumigate their family quickly. Give them Santa Claus to distract them from teaching their children the real meaning of Christmas. Give them the Easter Bunny so they won't talk about the resurrection and power over sin and death. Keep them too busy to go out in nature and reflect on God's creation. Send them to amusement parks, sporting events, plays, concerts, and movies instead. Keep them busy, busy, busy. And when they meet for spiritual fellowship, involve them in gossip and small talk so they leave with troubled consciences. Crowd their lives with so many good causes, they have no time to seek the power of Jesus. Soon they will be working with their own strength, sacrificing their health and family for the good of the cause. It will work! It will work! It is quite a plan. The demons went eagerly to their assignments, causing Christians everywhere to get busier and more rushed, going here and there, having little time for their God and their family, having no time to tell others about the power of Jesus. I guess the question is, has the devil been successful in his schemes? You be the judge.